Hey there. Lately I've been in a slump and haven't been posting any videos because I was unsure what to make. Well, this past week I was watching Top Chef and one of the finalists made an alligator soup. It was supposed to be a big challenge and it got me thinking. How would I make an alligator soup? And since I was finally able to find some alligator meat around here, I'm going to go ahead and try it. On my scale here, it says I got about 15.9, 1 pound of alligator meat here. So I'm going to take that and I'm going to split it right in half and get about 8 ounces of this alligator meat for the soup. So now I have 2 4-ounce pieces of alligator tail. I'm going to put that in my pan. I'm going to turn it on medium high here. And I'm going to let that simmer in 1 cup of chicken broth until it's just tender enough to flake apart. Alright, while that's simmering on the stove, I'm going to take my other half of alligator tail here. And I'm going to cut it into chunks. I'm basically just going to make fried pieces of alligator tail, like fried shrimp or anything else like that. So I'm going to cut that into appropriate sized pieces for frying up. Should be about like this. Now that I've got those all cut into these strips, I'm going to put them in my container here. And I'm going to put some egg over the top of them. I'm going to beat that egg up a little bit. Okay, after I beat that egg up a little bit, I'm going to put some Old Bay seasoning in there. About a teaspoon of Old Bay seasoning. Also to this mixture, I'm going to add some Louisiana hot sauce. A little under a teaspoon of hot sauce. And just mix that up. Alright, now I'm going to set those to the side. I have a little more than a half a cup of flour in there. It doesn't need to be precise, about a half a cup of that. Now I'm going to add about a half a teaspoon of garlic powder, half a teaspoon of fresh ground pepper, and a half a teaspoon of salt. I'm just going to mix that up. And that's our batter that we're going to dip these fried alligator bits into when we're ready for those. Also, while waiting for our alligator to finish in the little pot over there, I'm going to get ready 1 clove of garlic and 1 shallot. And then those will be ready to put in our soup when the time is right. Okay, so now that our alligator meat has been in there for... it actually took longer than I thought. It's been in there about a half hour now. I'm going to take that and I'm going to strain the broth out, set that to the side. Okay, so after I've emptied this pan out, I'm going to put it back on the burner on medium heat. And in this I have 1 ounce of flour, 1 ounce of butter. I'm going to add that. Now what I'm doing with this is I'm going to make a really light roux. Once that's blended together nice, I'm going to add the garlic and the shallot. The shallot and the garlic. Stir that up. And then the broth that I reserved from the cooking alligator, I'm going to add that. Stir that in. I'm also going to add 3 ounces of white wine. And I'm going to add a half a cup of milk. And smooth that out. And I'm just going to turn that down to a low heat and let that simmer for about 20 minutes. Now in the meantime, over here we have to take our cooked alligator meat and I'm just going to shred that up. Once you have your alligator meat all finely cut up like this, you're going to take about 3/4 of it and put it in the blender. And then you're going to take some of your soup that you have in the pot, put that in the blender with the meat. Then to the blender, you're going to add about a half teaspoon, about a quarter teaspoon of nutmeg, some fresh ground black pepper, and about 4 ounces of milk or cream, and we're just going to blend that up until it's smooth. Now I'm going to put that back in the pan, and I'm just going to put it back on the stove and let it simmer on a real low heat for about 20 minutes or so, 20 minutes to a half hour, and you can see how nice that looks. So I'm just going to put the lid on that and stir it periodically, every 5 minutes or so. In the meantime, I'm going to get to work on our fried alligator. Okay, so I'm just going to take these pieces of alligator that have been in our egg wash for a while, and I'm going to roll them in our batter here. I'm turning my pan on high. I've got about a cup and a half, 2 cups of oil in there. And I'm just going to bread these. It's always good to have a dry hand and a wet hand when you're doing this operation here. Wet hand, dry hand. Okay, now that those are all battered, I'm just going to take them one at a time and put them into our grease here. And I'm going to get all of those in there and fry them up. Alright, these are frying up pretty good. Just flip them. You want to be careful when you're flipping them to not tear the batter off. So kind of grab them from the side instead of top and bottom. Like that. Alright, so now you can see how nice and golden these are. Now to kind of take them out and let them drain on some paper towel. Alright, so there it is. It's my alligator soup. I gave it a little bit of Louisiana flair and I put a crawfish in there. I've got my fried alligator here, and under there is some nice cocktail sauce. So this is my dish, alligator lunch. Enjoy.
We flying high above the clouds again, looking down from the clouds at the moon that I see. Never know when up or down you wait. Only thing they know that I'm believing that it's ever known. Maybe if it was an IOD, any man, any girl, everybody in the